campaign's ties to Russia. Important now to welcome the man who wrote two books about special prosecutors and American presidents. Ken Gormley is the author of The Death of American Virtue, Clinton versus Starr, and Archibald Cox, Conscience of a Nation. He's also the president of Duquesne University and a professor of law. Why do we have special prosecutors, special counsel?
Well, Michael, going all the way back to Teapot Dome and then the Watergate special prosecution investigation, the whole idea is when there is evidence of potential criminal wrongdoing at the top of the executive pyramid, you want the most neutral, objective person to look at that. So there can be no doubt in the minds of the American public. This is all about reassuring the American public that the American system of justice works properly. So you must get the most neutral person so that you know that this investigation is not tied to politics, so that people can have confidence in the ultimate result.
Nixon and Trump both fired individuals investigating their administrations. Is the comparison really that simple?
Well, it isn't, in the sense that President Nixon fired Archibald Cox, whose biography I wrote, really after the whole Watergate cover-up had boiled to a crescendo and Cox had subpoenaed these 8 critical tape recordings from the White House and Nixon wouldn't give them to him, and the federal courts ordered him to, and he defied him and fired Cox. So we had reached a point of culminating event. Here, this was early on in the presidency. The president does have power, for instance, to remove an FBI director, although it's rare. The fact that this was tied in, however, to a potential investigation of either President Trump or his own administration or campaign, that's what does make the comparison somewhat apt.
President Trump thinks this is a witch hunt. That makes him far from unique among his predecessors.
Well, that's true. I mean, pretty much every president who's been the subject of special prosecutor investigations has viewed them with, disdain and treated them as witch hunts. Certainly when I interviewed President Clinton, he felt as if from the moment he entered the White House, he had barely turned the key on the door and there were investigations lining up of him. Certainly President Ronald Reagan was not fond of the Iran-Contra investigation. So that is natural. However, it is crucial that presidents understand, because these have become a part of American political life, and they are like a sword of Damocles, and you have to treat the process with respect and move forward and let it work its course.
Fair to say, Dr. Gormley, that the rest of us now should just let it breathe and take its own course and allow governance, hopefully, to take place?
Well, I think that's the key thing. You know, what was great about this decision by Rod Rosenstein, Michael, is that the selection of Robert Mueller is about as down the middle as you could get. Look at it. This is one of the first things that Democrats and Republicans have been able to agree on in Washington for a long time. So we have someone in place who we know has impeccable integrity, is neutral. They have to do their job. A good special prosecutor, you have to understand, is you're not going to hear from them. You're not going to hear every day. This isn't a soap opera. This isn't a TV show. They're going to put their heads down and do their work. And that's now what the White House needs to do, what Congress needs to do. The Attorney General and the Deputy Attorney General are freed from this matter, so they can all go about doing their work. And one of the most sobering things in my work on the Clinton book was the discovery that in 1996 there was a then unknown assassination attempt of President Clinton in the Philippines, and the Secret Service got some information that there was a possible bomb under a bridge. FBI or Secret Service Director Lou Merletti diverted the motorcade. They found a bomb big enough to blow up the whole entourage. Later they discovered it was planted there by a then little known terrorist named Osama bin Laden. So one of the sobering things, Michael, is as we as a country were obsessed with Whitewater and Paula Jones, Monica Lewinsky, sex scandals, impeachment, people inside and outside our country were plotting our attack that led to 9/11. So it's a sobering reminder that there is important business to do, as you said in your opening remarks. And that's now that we have this part of things locked down with a special prosecutor with the utmost integrity. That should be left alone. People should go about their work. He will do his job.
It's a very sobering message from Ken Gormley, the president of Duquesne University. We need to keep our focus on everything, not just this. Thank you for being here. I appreciate it.
Always a pleasure, Michael.
What are your thoughts? Tweet me at Smirkanish, go to my Facebook page, and I'll read some of the responses throughout the course of the program. Hit me, Catherine. Maybe you should be his counsel. Diane, I think I just gave him good advice. The question for this president is whether he's capable of following advice. I fear that no one around him is willing to share with him bad news, and also that he's unacceptive of bad news when it is provided. One more if we have time for it. Because there is no evidence, only anonymous sources, laugh out loud, just hysteria, biased media, you at CNN getting crazier and crazier on these sources. Hey, Tony, hang on. Just hang on. I got to pause now. You're going to throw off my clock, but I'm going to do it. That's the page one story in the New York Times today, right? It's the story that has the nut job quote. It's also the story that the president said to the Russians, I faced great pressure because of Russia. That's been taken off, seemingly an element of obstruction of justice. Hey, I fired Comey to get beyond that pressure, to relieve the pressure. How do we know this unsourced material, according to you? Matthew Rosenberg was just here explaining that it came from notes provided by a person in the room. So you can be dismissive of this and say, oh, it's more leaking, but sooner or later, you're going to have to deal with the substance. The leaking bothers me, of course, but the substance, I'm not going to ignore that.